Ariel Helwani post-fight at Bellator 222 alongside Chael Sonnen following his fight against Lyoto Machida. Chael, I appreciate you doing this.
Came in second in that one, Helwani. I got the silver medal. Did you see that? Real back and forth battle.
I was very proud of you tonight.
Thank you, my friend. Thank you.
How are you feeling?
I feel good. Listen, I don't mind losing to his positions. You know, some of those knees and stuff I knew were going to be tricky. But it was a frustration for me to lose in my own positions. He's in it. He was on top of me. And I felt a couple of times that I could have gotten up, but it was an effort issue. And Ariel, I just think I fired my last bullet.
How close were you to being out in the first round?
Oh, my goodness. It's hard to say. He actually had some ground and pound that surprised me. Some of those fists he was turning over and whatnot. And again, there was an opportunity to get up. And I was confused more than anything. Well, how'd this guy get on top of me? How'd we end up here again? And overall, he was a very good fighter. Really hard to get pinned down. I mean, there's always space, and then when he came in, he'd show you a hand, he'd show you a foot, and then he'd knee. You're blocking three things at once. It was difficult.
He timed those knees very well, right, when you were shooting, once in the first and then once in the second.
Yeah, that's right. I think he knew I was greedy for a takedown. It was hard. I got my hands on him at one point. I thought there was some opportunity there, but it was not to be.
In your mind going into this fight, did you tell yourself if you didn't win that you were going to retire?
No. I fully thought I was going to win this fight. I was going to call out Ryan Bader. I had the whole thing ready. But, you know, I really do. I dug deep. I've had a hard life. You know, I worked really hard my whole life for a lot of goals. And I swear to goodness, I think you have like a scale. And I've just used up all my toughness. I really have. I feel like I'm not as tough as I used to be. I don't want it as bad as I used to want. I used to walk through stuff like this. And tonight, you know, the referee, when he stopped the fight, he looked at me and said, Chael, I'm trying to help you. I said, what took you so long? We had no problem with this. I quit fighting 4 minutes ago. Why did we even go to the break? So here we are.
So how did you make that decision? What was going on in your mind when you decided to take off the gloves and do that?
Well, yeah, I was on a bit of a championship run. If I beat Lyoto tonight, I would have fought Bader for the world championship. And that was the only reason I was in the sport, you know. I promised my father I'd I was just in the sport.
Do you leave with any regrets?
No. I loved every minute.
It's beautiful to have your son and daughter here. I know your wife.
Too. Look at this guy. Yeah.
What was
He's
it like?
Good, this one.
This is the first time you fight in front of them live, correct?
Yeah, that's right.
What was that like?
It was great. I mean, we had a lot of fun. It was a family affair, and we're not done. You know, we're still part of the Bellator family. We're going to get on a plane and go out to London. We're going to call some fights. And I got plenty of energy to call fights, Ariel. But as far as getting in there and going with some of these guys and trying to reclaim a championship or get back even to a number one contenders fight, it's tough. You know, my last 13 fights were all against world champions in three different weight classes. I beat 11 of them, but I didn't beat them all, and my time has ended.
You know how retirements go in this sport.
Yeah.
Do you know definitively that this is it for you?
Yes. I'm a man of my word. I told Scott Coker I would give him five fights. I gave him those five fights. It was up tonight. I'm not done competing. I'm still the defending Abu Dhabi Super Fight champion. I will defend my Super Fight belt at Abu Dhabi. But as far as MMA, I am done.
And what a great honor for you. You retire undefeated and undisputed.
Undefeated and undisputed. Three different weight classes. The greatest fighter the sport has ever seen.
And could I ask just before we go, how do you want Chael Sonnen to be remembered? Your legacy is a very interesting one. And I don't know if you know this. You probably don't. You're being showered with praise and love online right now. You've had your ups and your downs. How do you want to be remembered in this sport?
Well, that was very beautiful. I will tell you, in fairness, I don't really want to be remembered in the sport for too long. For tonight, you know, be nice to me, and that'll make me feel good because it's going to be a hard night for me. But, you know, I kind of remember those guys when I was in high school. They'd come back to the football games after they graduated wearing their Letterman's jacket. And I thought that was a weird thing. It's like, you know, you got to move on in life. And I got some beautiful kids and a beautiful wife, and I'm looking forward to what they want to do. And whether it's MMA or wrestling, the things that I love, whatever they want to do, I'm going to be the chauffeur. And to answer how I'd like to be remembered, I was a competitor first, and when I started in this sport, it was true tough guys that wanted to compete. We didn't need a bunch of money. We didn't need a bunch of cameras in front of us. We wanted to compete and find out who was the best. And if I could leave anything for the locker room and the boys in the back, I hope they find that spirit again.
Do you think you'll miss competing?
Oh, I'll miss it terribly. This is very hard for me. Yeah, this is all I know.
Is it harder than you expected? When you probably thought about this moment before, right?
Yeah, I've dreaded this moment before, and I didn't think it was going to come tonight, but it was an effort issue, and I didn't have the effort to get up off the bottom. I knew how to get off the bottom. I knew how to get off the bottom from a guy that didn't think I'd be there. And it's time. I got to walk away.
And you obviously have a career in broadcasting, but would you like to remain as a coach? Or are you going to remain a part of the team at ATT now in Oregon?
Yeah, I'll be remaining part of the team. I don't know how much I'll be coaching as much as being there supporting, you know, Jake Smith and Austin Vander, for many other names. I better not start the name game. But some guys I'm very close with that did a lot for me. And now it's my turn to try to, you know, get back and make sure I'm there for them, even if it's from the outside. But my days of going in there and grinding and sweating and sacrificing, I think, in fairness, are behind me.
Chael, it has been an honor, my friend.
It really has been.
It's been quite the ride.
A lot of people say that, like they feel they have to, but you mean it.
I mean it. It has been such a pleasure covering your career. You have given us so much time, so many great moments, so many great memories. You always made it fun for us through the good and the bad, and I'm honored to call you a partner. I really enjoy working with you, and I'm looking forward to many years together.
That's very beautiful. Thank you for that, Ariel.
Congrats on a great career.
Thank you.